There was always this feeling, extremely personal, for objects I made for me and for other ones. This feeling has never called my attention as if it might be something special. It had been always there. Today, I know that, in the bottom of my work as an architect, I followed the path of those passions, even obsessions, trying to understand them and make them better. And when I began to reconsider it from my youth, I've been adding new images and passions to the old ones. I tend to think that somehow I've known since always the emotional core of new discoveries. I work surrounded by mountains in a village near Karambundi. I work from there, I live there, and many times I ask myself if this influences my work, and I don't really dislike the idea of imagining that it could be this way. Will my houses be different if I wouldn't work for the last 25 years in Karambundi, but in my childhood landscape by the end of the road of Jura in Switzerland, with wavy hills and close to the urbanization of the city of Basel? As soon as I begin to reflect about this issue, I understand the work that leads me to other many places. When I focus on a determined place where I create a project, I try to comprehend its structure, its history, and the sensorial characteristics start to join with images from other places. Places I know, places that amaze me, images of everyday places, or special places, that somehow I have inside of me as a symbol of determined moods and qualities, and images of places or architectural situations that comes from environment as plastic arts, cinema, literature, theater. This is how I immerse to the side of my project. I track it, and at the same time, I look outside to the other world of my other places. Buildings that unfold a special presence in a determined site produce the impression of being tied up to an internal tension that aims beyond the site. Buildings found the space granting a testimony to the world. If a project sustained only by the existing conditions and the tradition of the site, if the project repeats what this place points out, in my opinion, there is a lack of confrontation with the world. I have never been a good observer, and truthfully, I never wanted to be one. I like to capture atmospheres, move between the middle of determined special situations, and I feel satisfied when I accomplish to retain a sensation, a strong general impression from which, afterwards, I can capture details. For instance, the intense contemplation of a painting, extract particularities and ask myself, what triggers in me the feeling of passion, of withdrawal, of lightness, or amplitude that stays in my memory? Thoughtfully, it seems impossible to distinguish architecture from life, the spatial situation and the experience of it. Even if I only focus on architecture and try to comprehend what is what I see, the experience reverbs in me, inking what happened. Other memories try to interfere from similar experiences, and overlap with architectural situations related to them. In the table to the right, two women have a vivid conversation. One of them speaks American English, the other one Swiss German. None of them says a word in the language of the other one. The voices of the group on the next table sound delightfully distant. Each time I see the situation, I let myself engage to the atmosphere. Busy with their conversation and their business, people seem to feel happy. They behave naturally, and they do not feel mad about the presence of the other people. From time to time we found each other with our faces, and busy like I am now, it does not bother me to know that they're near me, in this space where everybody have a good appearance. React by our own intuition. We can make images, we can produce in the images, like intervene. We do this, but you can also do these daydreams. Dreams are easy to see, that you can see real spaces, a real perfect space you've never seen before, so your brain obviously can do things. This is what I'm trying to provoke to my brain, my heart, to create images, to create architecture.